Chapter 10. The Rosy Princess and the Yellow Elf. Once there lived an elf. He was yellow all over, right up to his nose. He was so yellow that he came to be known by the name the Yellow Elf. He whizzed here, he whizzed there. He whizzed everywhere. When someone looked at him, he looked like a beam of sunlight. He would splash his color onto the buttercups and make them bright and yellow. He would sit in the center of dancing daisies, yellow roses, and yellow marigolds, but when anyone stopped to admire the color of the buttercups or daisies, he would hurriedly vanish.
"Yellow, yellow,"
his mother called him one day. "Yellow, where are you?" His mother was soft and gentle yellow in color, except for her shining blue eyes. "Where is that boy?" muttered his mother. "He should come home. He's always whizzing around." Finally, Yellow came home, shining as brightly as ever. "There you are," said his mother. "I have a letter from the King of Red and his Queen of Light. Their daughter, the Rosy Princess, has vanished from the sky. They have asked for your help to rescue her." Yellow, being a brave elf, wasted no time and immediately flew up into the sky. He went round the earth until the sunlight did not reach him. There he saw the Rosy Princess dying away in the darkness.
"Rosy Princess! Rosy Princess!"
cried Yellow, but to no avail. The night was getting darker, and only the silvery sickle-shaped moon and stars were listening. The farther he flew to catch the Rosy Princess, the darker it grew. Soon he was alone. The moon and stars were gone. All around him, the darkness deepened and grew. And the darker it grew, the smaller Yellow became, until he was nothing but a spark of light.
"I'd better not blink,"
thought Yellow.
"For if I close my eyes, even for an instant, I might also vanish altogether."
And he stretched out his tiny hands to feel his way forward. That's when Yellow found the Rosy Princess. He couldn't see her, but he felt her warmth in the darkness. He reached out and took her warm hands in his. She was very still, and he knew at once that she was in a deep sleep.
"Come, my Rosy Princess,"
said Yellow.
"Wake up."
Yellow led her towards the morning sky. He lifted her up, and as they rose, the darkness disappeared. And the tired moon went to bed in the far, far western sky. The Rosy Princess grew redder, and the sunny elf grew ever brighter until they caught the sun's rays, and over the earth they soared.
"She's back! She's back! Our Rosy Princess is back!"
cried the King of Red and his Queen of Light as they saw the morning sky filled with a red glow. As a reward for bringing back the Rosy Princess, the King of Red and his Queen of Light married their daughter to Yellow, the elf, under a rainbow arch. After that, every morning, the Yellow Elf and the Rosy Princess come down to visit the earth. You can still see them at dawn when the sky in the east is filled with hues of yellow and red.